podcast host of Life's the Shuffle. Today I'm discussing I'm scared, but if not now, when? So most of us know, well, most of you know, but not all, I will be leaving California. So in California, I'm born and raised from San Diego, originally moved to San Jose about 14 years ago. And I would move to Washington to pursue other ventures. And the reason why I'm scared is because I have a personal training business out here. I've been doing it for the last 3.5, almost 4 years. Obviously, in-person training, clients can't go with you. You can still do virtual training, you still do Zoom training, you can still do all kinds of app-based training, but they won't be coming with me. Bulk of my business is, 95% of my business is in-person training. I do have a few clients that are virtual and a few clients that are app-based training. So the reason I'm discussing today is that all of us are scared of taking that chance or taking that leap. And we get stuck of, well, if I do this, this may happen. Well, if I do that, that's the unknown. But personally, I'm scared. If 95% of my clients are in person, they can't come with me to Washington, not Washington DC for sure, but Washington State, how am I gonna make money? What am I gonna do? And that's the biggest reason why I'm scared, because I don't know what to do. But I do know this, is I'm a person that once I set a goal, just like anybody else, you're able to conquer that. But most of us limiting our goals is the fact that we're stuck in this fear. My fear is I lack up. Lack is I won't have money to, you know, afford my groceries, the morning before I might have money to pay rent or have money to, you know, just do daily necessities, wash your laundry, do your clothes or whatever the case may be. I'm stuck with what do I do? But I said to myself, well, what do I want for my future? Have you ever been in Silicon Valley, San Jose? We're living on top of each other. I mean, small spaces, a lot of people, overabundance, overcrowded with just a lot of different things. I even miss the mom and pop businesses because there were so much corporations out there, from Carl's Jr. to McDonald's to Starbucks, you name it, it's here. Most people will say, well, it's a heart of Silicon Valley, that's where you need to be at, but where's my heart? You know, what I vision for my life for the next 10 to 15 years, I want a front and backyard. And most houses, unless you have a $2 million house, you can't afford that. So what do I want? As I pursue doing something different, mentor coaching, transitioning from in-person training to becoming a mentor coach, how does that look? What do I want? Now, obviously, I can get back and going out there to Washington and get involved in the gym and do the whole rat race of becoming a trainer, a new gym, starting over again. But is that really what you want for the future? No, it's not. And the reason I'm scared is, again, the fear keeps showing up, money, lack. And obviously, most of us have different fears in our life, different fears that show up, and they don't go away easily. The only way to conquer a fear or a lack or a belief is to actually challenge that. The fear is lack of not having the money when I move to Washington, but in reality, is that really true? No, it's not. So as I transitioned from leaving in-person training to moving to Bellingham, Washington, I asked myself one important question. If not now, when? Because if we get caught up with what's the right time, what's the perfect time, this is the wrong time, COVID, shelter in place. Okay, that's great. We know that is there. Okay, so then what next? So I always ask my question when it comes to making huge decisions, if not now, when? If you can't answer when, then obviously now is the perfect time because we don't see what the future is. We all can know in the present. But the process is, trust the process. What you're doing is right. If you believe you can achieve it, you will. Most of us have a fear of something, and if every fear is different per person, the difference is how you challenge that fear. Fear stands for false evidence appearing real. So my fear is lack of not having the money. So that proves to be real for me. But in reality, that is not true. I will be okay. Before I made the step to move to Washington, I said to myself, you know what, Ron, you may not be able to take clients with you, but you will be okay. And again, if not now, when? So that's why I'm shooting these videos to tell you guys, you yourself right now have a fear of taking a big leap. But without taking risk, you'll never know success. Without challenging yourself, you never know your unfulfilled potential. And my goal in life is become a full-time mentor coach, not doing it part-time and also training part-time, become a motivational speaker. So if not now, when? And part of me doing this will be allowing me to take the chances I need and learn about myself. Move to an unfamiliar place. I've never been to a place called Bellingham, Washington at all. Not even visited, not even drove through. To give you an idea, it's about an hour and 30 minutes north of Seattle and about an hour and 10 minutes south of the Vancouver-Canadian border. So I've been meeting new people, but it's great. I'm 37 years old, and why, if not now, when? You know, as you get older, you get slower. You know, you don't have that energy, you know, anymore. So while you're young, take those chances. Go out there and make something happen. Because you're still alive and you do a lot of things in your life. So that's two. I'm story, I'm scared. But if not now, when? See, all this fear can come up with stopping me from doing things I really, really want. And that's what fear does. It stops you from doing things you really want. Now, granted, it does help keep you safe. But if I want to achieve a goal of owning a house or a front and backyard, becoming a full-time mentor coach, becoming a full-time motivational speaker, when will it happen? If I don't trust the process and actually try to go towards doing those things, they will never happen. So I know you guys out there, it's about 4 o'clock in the morning out here in California. I'm quite sure someone else is in the morning time, but ask yourself, what do you envision 10 years from now? Why do you envision, and what are you going to do to achieve it? And that's how you start trusting the process of getting those goals. Because you can achieve unfulfilled potential anytime, any place, because you are still alive. You have the challenge to do anything you want. So again, this is Ron Johnson, mentor coach. I'm here to help you. If you're stuck, unfulfilled, need help, I'm here to help.